السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Inshallah, we'll recite a few verses of the opening chapter of the Quran, and thereafter we will start our address. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين صدق الله العظيم. Ramadan Mubarak and Kareem to all of you and your families, and may Ramadan be a means of blessing and Mubarakan for the entire ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May this month be a means of all of us restoring, repairing, and reviving our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Al-Quran Al-Kareem. When we start Salatul Taraweeh, the first thing we recite is Surah Al-Fatiha, and in Surah Al-Fatiha, there is a verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. If we internalize this verse for a second, it will bring shivers to our back. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Oh Allah, You alone do we worship, and You alone do we seek assistance from as well. Jesus, alayhi salatu wasalam, He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُوهُ. He said, certainly Allah is my Lord and Allah is your Lord. So worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't wait to get old to worship Allah. Don't wait to get old to worship Allah. If today is your last day, you are old already. Our worship, remember, is not a gift from us to Allah. Rather, it is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in Al-Quran Al-Kareem as well, يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. We have not done Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a favor, or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a favor, by subscribing to Islam. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done us a favor by giving us the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. As far as reviving our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is concerned, we cannot do that unless and until we revive our relationship with who? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Quran al-Kareem, you will find a common theme. أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One cannot obey Allah while disobeying the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conjoined His love by following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we follow the sunnah, we have revived and renewed our relationship with Sayyidul Awwaleen wal Akhireen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, if you love Allah, in kuntum tuhibbun Allah, if we love Allah, what is the recipe for that? What is the litmus test? What is the criteria? فَاتَّبِعُونِ. Follow my sunnah. Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's way. And when we follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's way, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah will love us and He will forgive us. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-loving and the all-forgiving. Today has been a busy day. I'm going to end with one last hadith. Ramadan is a month of self-development. It is a month of self-purification. It is a month where we need to unlearn all of the things which are cancerous to our hearts. It is a month where our heart must be purified. And one of the greatest sunnah, if not the greatest sunnah, of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one day Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala an, he says, An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called me. And he said, Ya Bunayya, he said, my son, in qadarta, if you have the wherewithal, if you have the strength and the endurance and the discipline and the resolve, and this is what this month is all about, my brothers and sisters. It is about discipline, it is about resolve, it is understanding that no pain, no gain, there are no elevators to success. We all must take the steps. So he says, if you have the wherewithal, in qadarta an tusbiha wa tumsiya, وَلَيْسَ فِي قَلْبِكَ غِشٌ لِأَحَدٍ فَفْأَلْ. If you can rise every morning and retire every night in a state that you don't have any enmity or jealousy or grudges or hatred against anyone, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, then do that. This is what this month is all about, folks. This is it. This is the message of the month of Ramadan. And if you do that, know that وَذَٰلِكَ مِن سُنَّتِي. This is among the most mountainous, the most important sunnah and sunan as far as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned. And thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ أَحْيَى سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي. And whoever revives my sunnah and restores and repairs my sunnah, that person has loved me. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. And whoever loves me, let us keep our eyes on the prize. Let us keep our eyes on the prize. And whoever loves me, that person will be with me in Jannatul Firdaus. اللهم أهله علينا بالأمن والإيمان والسلامة والإسلام. O Allah, we ask you that Ramadan dawns upon the entire Ummah and humanity in a state of safety and security, in a state of love, healing, and hope, and mercy, in a state of salam and peace, and Islam as well. Enjoy your Salatul Taraweeh. Enjoy worshipping Allah. And inshallah, we will see you all tomorrow for Salatul Jumu'ah at 2:30 p.m. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillah. Ya Allah. Oh.